Blue White's mother died, the king, her father, up and cried,
"Oh, what a nuisance, what a life. Now I must find another wife."
It's never easy for a king to find himself that sort of thing. He wrote to all the magazines and said, "I'm looking for a queen." At least 10,000 girls replied and begged to be the royal bride. The king said with a shifty smile,
"I'd like to give each one a trial."
However, in the end, he chose a lady called Miss MacDlose, who brought along a curious toy that seemed to bring her endless joy. No, it was a mirror, framed in brass, a lovely talking looking glass. Ask it anything, day or night, it always got the answer right. For instance, if you were to say, "Oh, mirror, what's for lunch today?" the thing would answer in a trice, "Today it's scrambled eggs and rice." Every day, week in, week out, the spoiled and stupid queen would shout, "Mirror, mirror on the wall, who's the fairest of them all?" The mirror answered every time, "Madam, you are the queen divine. You are the only one to charm us. Queen, you are the cat's pajamas." For 10 whole years, the silly queen repeated this absurd routine, till suddenly, one awful day, she heard the magic mirror say, "From now on, queen, you're number 2. Snow White is prettier than you." The queen went absolutely wild. She yelled, "I'm going to scrag that child. I'll cook her flaming goose, I'll skin her, I'll eat her rotten guts for dinner." She called the huntsman to her study. She shouted at him, "Listen, buddy, you take that filthy girl outside and see you take her for a ride. Thereafter, slit her ribs apart and bring me back her bleeding heart." The huntsman dragged the lovely child deep, deep into the forest wild. Fearing the worst, poor Snow White spake. She cried, "Oh, please, give me a break." The knife was raised, the arm was strong. She cried again, "I've done no wrong." The huntsman's heart began to flutter. It melted like a pound of butter. He murmured, "Okay, beat it, kid." You can bet your life she did. Later, the huntsman made a stop within the local butcher shop. There he bought, for safety's sake, a bullock's heart and one nice steak. "Oh, Majesty, oh, Queen," he cried, "the rotten little girl has died. Just to prove I did not cheat, I brought along these bits of meat." The Queen cried out, "Bravissimo! I trust you killed her nice and slow." This is the disgusting part. The Queen sat down and ate the heart. Oh, no, she cooked it well. Wild heart can be as tough as hell. While all this was going on, oh, where had Snow White gone? Well, she found it easy being pretty to hitch a ride into the city. And there she got a job, unpaid, as common cook and chambermaid to 7 funny little men, each one not more than 3'10". Ex-racehorse jockeys, all of them. These 7 dwarfs, though awfully nice, were guilty of one shocking vice. They squandered all of their resources at the racetrack backing horses. And when they headed back to winter, none of them got any dinner. One evening, Snow White said, "Look here, I think I've got a great idea. Just leave it all to me, okay? And no more gambling till I say." Night at eventide, young Snow White hitched another ride, and then, when it was very late, she slipped inside the palace gate. The king was in his counting house, counting out his money. The queen was in the parlor, eating bread and honey. The footman and the servant slept, so no one saw her as she crept on tiptoe through the mighty hall and grabbed the mirror off the wall. As soon as she had got it home, she told the senior dwarf, or gnome, to ask it what he wished to know. "Go on," she shouted, "have a go." "Oh, magic mirror, please don't joke. Each of us is stony broke. Which horse will win tomorrow's race? Half-pot, gold cup, steeplechase." "Mirror, is very sweet and low.
The horse's name is Mistletoe. The dwarfs went absolutely daft. They kissed young Snow White fore and aft, then raced away to raise some dough with which to back old Mistletoe. They pawned their watches, sold the car, borrowed money from near and far, for much of it they had to thank the manager of Dundrum AIB Bank. They went to Ascot, and of course, for once they backed the winning horse. They're after every single day. The mermaid the bookies pay. Each dwarf and Snow White got a share, and each was soon a millionaire, which shows that gambling's not a sin, provided that you always win.